Front door to heaven
is Stargate.
Yeah, mic check, 1, 2. They see me rolling, they hating, patrolling, they trying to kiss me.
Rum and nerdy,
kiss me, 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 rum and nerdy.
Whenever I'm about to do something, I think, would an idiot do that? And if they would, I do not do that thing.
You wanna play? I'll play. This is the way.
Ready the program!
Let's go!
Hey everybody, welcome to Rum and Nerdy. I'm Greg.
And I'm Garrick.
Today we have episode 2.26. And this one's called He Came Bearing Gifts.
Because he came bearing gifts.
Welcome back, Aaron.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
We had, and I don't know if it's directly attributed to you, but 2% of our overall listeners last week were in China. And I don't know if you've got, like, family there.
Not anymore. I used to.
Or the government knows what company you work for, and they're like, hey, maybe he spilled some industry secrets.
There you go.
Could have been. You don't know.
Well, we're trying to build our Asian listenership, so we brought you back just in case. No, actually, we were talking about something completely different. Happened to have a meeting over here at the studio, and since Garrick and I were going to record, we just said...
Well, that and Aaron said, hey, if we do the meeting at your place, I'll bring some rum. Perfect.
And I said, God damn it.
And then he brought a lot of rum.
Yeah, some good stuff.
Two of which I don't think we've had.
Correct. This Cane Island, Venezuela. And apparently there's several different Cane Islands. There's a Jamaican, the Venezuela, and a couple others.
It definitely looked like the White Claw of rums.
Yeah. I mean, I saw it at the store, and I was like, well, okay, I've been enough times in Venezuela that anything that says Venezuela on it, I'm going to read.
I got a keychain with your name on it.
Yeah. And I don't want to know. But I was like, oh, Venezuelan rum. Yeah, no, I need to try that just
Cane Island, Venezuela rum. Okay,
it says Northeast region.
Curiosity, distillery
location.
$25.
Okay. So distillery location is the Northeast region, which is...
It's like Margarita or Maracaibo.
It's like almost meaningless.
It's like the Omaha of Venezuela. Not really.
Beautiful
spot. Distillery name, Distilleria Sofa?
Easy for you to say.
Sure. Type of aging, American white oak casks. Why has it got to be a white cask?
That's racist.
Why has it got to be American?
We didn't go and buy this specialty foreign rum only to have it aged in freaking American wood. What the hell?
Very disappointing.
Although, hold on. Let me step back on all of that. Mm. Venezuela is in America.
It's just South America.
It's still in America.
That's true.
So, as far as we know, that's locally sourced American white oak casks.
Yeah.
Okay.
The dirt practically.
That's a common mistake that I often hear from foreigners is that we often attribute the word America with the United States of America, and that's not true. America is like this whole pie wedge of the globe.
Yeah.
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 Western Hemisphere.
Yeah. The evil West.
Type of still, column still. I've never seen that published on a bottle before.
And I was hoping you guys knew what that was.
Okay, there's a pot still.
Yeah.
And then there's a column still, which looks like a giant oboe.
Mm. Yeah, kind of. That's a good way to describe it.
Yeah.
We did a tour, the group I was with. Garrick wasn't with me, but when I was in Kansas City, I did a...
Oh, I thought you were going to go to Great Lakes Distillery in Wisconsin.
Oh, yeah. No, I was going to say...
Because they had both.
We did Tomstown in Kansas City, which is primarily whiskey. They make a gin that tastes like... I'm eating up juniper bush. I fucking hate gin. Anyway, they have a 2.5 story still.
2.5 story.
Oh yeah. It like when you're down in the it's a converted old newspaper plant or whatever. But when you're on the first floor, it's there and it goes up through the ceiling. And then they've got a special vent space that this thing crosses through into a
that'd like be neat
a
to see
15 foot height specialty room. And it's just. Goes through and you see everything percolating and all the copper and everything piping everything through.
Okay,
it's really cool.
So this is really interesting. So where do you think this was bottled?
New Jersey.
Miami.
Amsterdam.
That's nearby.
And then was imported into Stamford, Connecticut. So there's
imported
that.
Into or by somebody in Stamford, Connecticut?
Imported by.
Yeah, so they, for okay. whatever reason, a lot of importers up there.
That's like that rum, Dos Madeiras,
mm-hmm.
where it's 2+5. It's 5-year-aged Caribbean rum blended with 2-year-aged Spanish rum. It's aged all the shipped there.
So too. So this is interesting. So basically, all of this rum, it's spent the full 8 years in the barrel at the distillery. So it is a single cask rum. It right off the bat, it says no refilling of barrels and no Solara. And actually, it puts Solara in quotation marks. So I feel like they're. I don't feel like they like this. I thought I did there.
No Solara.
No refilling of barrels lasers. And no Solara aging.
Dun, dun, dun.
But an honest 8-year-old rum. Oh, it's 8. That's.
It's adorable.
That's cute. That's a cute rum. Enjoy the rum how you. I'm really curious to try this. This is. Enjoy this rum how you like it. Either straight.
By the way, I
on
really
the
just
rocks.
Censor myself. My dark sense of humor almost came out.
Yeah.
I could feel the force from
or in your favorite cocktail. Okay, well let's get cracking on this because yeah. I know.
Okay, do your thing. I'm gonna do my thing. Again, everybody, I'm gonna start off with one of our favorites. This isn't the one I thought. Here it is. Fat Rum Pirate. I thought I would pull it up on there. Fatrumpirate.com. We love the reviews.
I thought that said Fat Trump Irate.
Yeah.
This is a rum blog.
Changes the meaning of this review for sure. Cane Island are a new independent bottler. We have already covered their 8-year Barbados. As we said, there was a Jamaican too. A rather good one. Up next is 8-year-old Trinidad, which means to. Oh, wow. God, there's a Trinidad. There's a Jamaican. And which one do we have?
Venezuela.
We have Venezuela.
Oh, this review is
because,
the Trinidad.
Because Aaron is Venezuelan dish desk.
I mean, I've been to Trinidad a couple of times.
Yeah, I've never been there.
I was there for a week one night.
I've always wanted to go. It's on my list.
Port of Spain's nice. You know, I didn't get to go leave the airport too much, but it was on the list. Let's put it that way.
Gregario.
This is weird. This is the reviews. When I pull it up, I didn't notice it pulled it for the Trinidad.
Oh, you couldn't find it for the Venezuela?
I'm sure I can. Rumx.com. I don't know this group, but this is the right one now.
Yeah,
it's
that's
Venezuela,
correct.
Cane Island, 43% column steel molasses. I think you said all that. Venezuelan was produced in Venezuela, was selected and bottled by an independent bottler, Cane Island. It was distilled from molasses and column steel in the age of 8 years. Blah, 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 blah.
American white oak casks. Honestly, the bottle had a better review/description than this website. Well, that's.
That's saying something.
Well, it's also, it's like we're pulling up reviews and just happen to do the wrong review. Anyway, what are you guys getting on the nose?
I'm getting the kind of harshness that I would expect from an 8-year-old rum.
Yeah.
I know this isn't the Jamaican rum, but it smells like Jamaican style.
Molasses?
Initial sip is very smooth and buttery.
Yeah.
Way more than I thought.
Yeah. The spice comes at the end.
I'm not getting spice per se. There's the burn. There's
the burn.
A little bit of a burn.
Right.
But
no spice burn,
But
post-burn.
I would surprisingly...
An afterburn.
Surprising smooth, and I would say buttery.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's really interesting.
It's a smooth burn.
Hmm. Fun. What do you think, Eric? You're over there quiet.
Yeah, it's bit of a burn. I think it's less smooth. I'll give you buttery. I think it has a bit of the harshness that you get from a single cask. Not that you get. I think the Solara definitely mellows it out a little bit. So I feel like this rum is young and punchy at its 8 years of aging. But for $25, this is surprisingly good.
Yeah, I mean this would be one I'd be relatively happy to see in a bar. Usually bar rums, unless it's a rum bar, bar rums tend to suck.
I'm going to be honest with you. If I was at an airport and this bottle was next to the Sailor Jerry, the Captain, and the Malibu, I would go for this bottle all day long.
Yeah.
All day long. And you know what? I'm going to put a cube in it just for shits because we've been drinking it neat.
That's true.
You know, it's funny, too. Is
should we splash it with Coke or no?
I don't need it yet.
I don't need it. I just was curious.
So the usual progression is one because you can't...
You can't unsplash it.
Yeah, yeah. You can't un-coke a rum and coke. So you pour it neat.
What's the difference between a pregnant lady and a light bulb? You can unscrew a light... Anyway, so I do want to say, like, drinksandco.com
Drinks and Co.
Yeah, short for company, clearly.
Yeah, I got that. It just feels very amateurish.
Yeah, well, Drinks and Co. That puts it as an estimated $50.58 for this.
And how much?
It was not.
Yeah. It also says aging style, old. Yeah.
I see what they did there.
Yeah. This is the Catholic Church of expectations on age. Whoa. Yeah,
speaking of dark humor.
Yeah. It's like I couldn't pass it twice.
I mean, at Total Wine, it wasn't $30. It was well underneath $30.
Yeah. Well, they get, you know, bulk pricing. This is if you order it offline. Anyway, yeah. So it's pretty decent. Let me have a cube. Chill this down. I'm going to take another
sip. I'm going to let you touch your own eyes. I'm that
never touch another man's cubes.
I'm that kind of friend.
Did you get different ice?
I did. I got the adult ice.
Okay.
What's the little ice? What's that from?
It's from the door ice maker.
Oh yeah, that's lame. I like the freezer ice maker with the big cubes. Yeah,
well, I get it. I just was in a hurry because we were talking about the other thing.
I got it. No. For our pre-meeting, that was fine. But we had actually used up most of the ice for the pre-meeting, so I refilled the ice.
Yes.
Gotcha. It's interesting.
I enjoy this on the rocks better than I did neat.
I'll give you that.
I would say I'm very happy that my refrigerator gives me options of two different sizes ices, which is nice. I just wish I could have that pebble ice like you get at Sonic.
Oh, yeah. The not quite crushed ice.
I don't know if I need that in my life. I'm going to be honest with you.
That kind of ice is really ideal for tiki drinks. You see that a lot in a lot of tiki drinks.
And there is such a thing as good ice. I have flight attendant friends that when they land places, they will actually pick FBOs and pick airports based on the kinds of ice they're given for the airplane.
That might be weird.
No, that's a thing.
No, I'm saying it's a thing. I'm just saying that it's weird. I don't know.
We've all had that garbage ice.
Here's my problem with tiki drinks, because I drink at a level of lazy that I don't think most people are willing to prepare. Like, I will, much like tonight, because we have a very special refill, I'll gather all of the ingredients and I'll lay them all out in front of me with all of the tools and equipment and like, okay, I'm gonna make one of these. Fuck it, I'm just going to put the rum in a glass and move on with life. I don't...
Yeah, at a certain point, it's like cooking a gourmet meal for yourself.
Yeah.
Why? I just want to eat or just drink the stuff.
Put it in the glass, watch Stargate. I don't need pineapple juice Stargate. This late at night.
So
which Stargate are we talking about here? The one with...
Ooh, all of the Stargates.
I saw a thing, and I almost sent it. In fact, I might have sent it to you. I saw a TikTok. As we all know, I watch too many TikToks.
It's Greg's only form of social media. So.
Yeah. So I was watching this one, and it was like, what is the best fourth wall break in Stargate? And there's the one where she's kind of, I guess they're in an elevator, and she's humming the theme song for the show.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like, I don't remember that. And he looks and goes, are you humming? Yeah. And that's like the only thing.
Well, there was a whole
story arc where they were making a show about the show.
There was a whole story. Yeah, it was called like Wormhole Troopers.
Yeah, something
like that. And it was, and the because there was a there's a really nerdy reason why this one guy was getting all of these images, mm-hmm. and he ended up being the writer for this television show because he was like psychically linked with one of the Stargate.
Well, they did it for like the 100th episode thing. They did very meta deal.
They brought him back and all that anyway. But they recast the show and they actually had a full Stargate show. And eventually, the government said, "Yeah, we're just going to let him do it." And everyone's like, why are you letting him do it? They're like, plausible deniability. That way, if any of our stuff leaks, we can just say, no, you're misremembering that. You're thinking of this stupid sci-fi show that used to be on. But yeah, they had
that's not terrible.
They had
pretty good.
I hated everything you were describing until it was like that aha moment.
No, Stargate SG-1 is so well written and so well done. Yeah. They had another, in many aspects, Stargate SG-1 is like the Community of science fiction shows. You ever watch Community?
I did, yeah.
They did an episode of Stargate SG-1 all in marionettes.
Oh, yeah.
The entire episode.
My favorite episode of Community remains one of the paintball ones.
Oh, the paintball ones were so good.
Yeah. I think it was the first paintball one.
The second paintball one was where they did like the whole water world thing. Mm-mm. Was that the first one?
I don't know, but that wasn't the one I'm thinking of. The one I'm thinking of is where Ken Jeong comes in looking like the Al Pacino in Scarface. Mm.
That's Team America.
No, he comes in wearing like this ridiculous drug dealer suit.
With the paintball guns.
With the paintball gun.
Yeah. Did you watch Community?
I've seen it. I did not watch it religiously.
Holy crap. You got to go back and rewatch it.
There was a whole period of time I did not watch TV for 10 years.
Same.
Oh, good man.
Same. Community.
I was just too busy.
Community is a show that my sister forced me to watch. She's like, no, you're going to love the show. You have to watch the show. And like every year for Christmas, she would just give me like the DVDs of the show. Like, no, you're going to watch it. It's fucking... And nice. I procrastinated. Much like Stargate, I procrastinated and procrastinated. And eventually I watched it. I'm like, this is the greatest show ever on TV.
There's a lot of shows that Sandy and I watch like that. We're like... Oh, it's three seasons in, and everybody's right. You know what? We're just going to wait the two seasons and just watch it all at the same time.
Yeah. My favorite thing Stargate did is when they hired Ben Browder and Claudia Black away when Farscape ended. Mm. You guys ever watch Farscape?
No.
Again, it's like one of those ones I've seen.
So, first of all, Jim Henson, Creature Shop, did the whole thing.
Oh, we know.
We've got good friends.
We've been there. I have pictures taken with the
Farscape.
I need to see those later.
Yeah.
But I thought Farscape was one of the best science fiction shows that was ever done. Just from the puppets, from the story arcs, from the character development, from the conflicts and everything, I thought it was fantastic.
Because they were both done by Sci-Fi, the Sci-Fi Channel.
Yeah.
At that point in time.
Yeah, and then I think for the fourth and fifth seasons of Farscape, somebody else bought them.
Yeah, I know, because who...
And the fan outcry was so bad when they canceled it, they brought them back for a miniseries to clean it all up.
Yeah. Yes. And it's weird because Stargate SG-1, so there was the original movie, and then when SG-1 started, it was on Showtime, I think. And then it left Showtime and was picked up by Sci-Fi.
Yeah.
But so the formal watch order is the original 1994 film,
right?
Then Stargate Origins, then Stargate SG-1 seasons 1 through 7, and then you have to watch Stargate SG-1 seasons 8 through 10 and Stargate Atlantis seasons 1 through 3 because those intermingle.
They do, yep. I loved Atlantis.
And then you watch Stargate: The Ark of Truth, which was the made-for-TV movie. Then Stargate Continuum. Then you come back for Stargate Atlantis seasons 4 and 5.
Yep.
Sounds like a Doctor Who arc.
It really does. And then you finish up with there. And then you finish up with Stargate Universe.
Sorry, I'm in the background. I'm showing Aaron these.
I love Stargate pictures Universe too.
What's really interesting is
what's really funny is those are all from the Henson Studios. That wasn't from the Creature Shop. Yeah.
No, that was from the studio. But the interesting thing about this is, before Henson bought it, it was the Chaplin Studio.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
No.
But to Stargate Universe, I thought was also very well done.
Haven't seen it yet.
It is way different than everything else, which is why it didn't last long.
Oh.
But was it a show or a miniseries or two seasons?
Movie?
Two or three seasons it made it.
Really?
But it was who's the bad guy from Tomorrow Never Dies? Scottish actor.
Oh yeah.
The guy with the thing, the bullet in his head. Let me look it up.
So not the bad guy, but like one of the henchmen?
No, the bad guy. The one that was with Sophie Marceau. Hang on. To Google.
Zhao? The North Korean
dude? No. That was Dying of the Day.
Tomorrow Never Dies is the one with the newspaper.
Oh, crap.
Oh, I'm thinking of The World Is Not Enough. The World Is Not Enough.
Jesus Christ. Okay.
Oh, that's the one with the diamonds embedded in the dude's face?
No, that was Dying of the Day.
This is Pierce Brosnan with the Russian submarine.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hey, and Christmas Jones.
Yeah, yeah.
No. She was the Bond girl. That was her character name, Denise Richards.
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't like her. Anyway, let's take a quick break. We're already like a third through this. We're just rambling.
Oh, hey, we should come back for the refill.
One more reason to. We'll be right back.
Juanita, my darling, you sure you love me?
Si, senor.
You feel in your heart you will marry to me?
Si, senor.
You promise to love me the rest of your life?
Si, senor.
I love Juanita, my sweetheart from Venezuela. Yes, Juanita, my sweetheart from Venezuela. Eva, talk to me.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the refill. So, Garrick, you got something special happening. What's going on?
So, a friend of ours, a TEA friend, Joe, the TEA Joe, tagged me in a post earlier this week about a rum, and he's like, "This looks pretty interesting. Have you ever had it?" I'm like, "Nope," but it looks like something that Rum and Nerdy should review.
Clearly.
And in the back of my mind, I'm like, "Hey, I want to sample this rum on our next recording." So when Aaron's like, "Oh yeah, I'm coming over for this meeting. I'll bring a bottle of rum." I'm like, "That's awesome. Bring this one." And just scrolling through their website, they had a formula. They had a recipe here. I guess that's what the norms call it, for a Manhattan made with this rum. And I love Manhattans.
I love
a good Manhattan, and this looks like a really good recipe tailored for this rum. I want to try it.
Well, I'm going to introduce the rum real fast. It's the and I don't know if you know if I'm saying this right. Equiano, 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 Equiano,
Equiano,
Equiano,
Equiano. Okay,
sure.
There we go. Equiano,
rum. African and Caribbean rum.
Yep. So the Equiano Rum Company, Afro-Caribbean rum, first came across this rum at the Boutique Rum Fest in London. For those not familiar with the London Rum Fest, God, I'm going to London next week. I wonder if that's when it is. On a Friday afternoon, they opened up what they called the Boutique Rum Fest. I'm just going to skip to the good part.
Oh, you're never going to believe who bottled this.
Bamboo?
Foursquare.
Yeah, I can totally believe that. Equiano Rum Company is a blend of molasses-based rums from Gray's Distillery and Foursquare Rum Distillery. Firstly, column distilled rum from Gary's is aged.
From Gary?
Gray's. Sorry, from Gray's.
Gary,
is
Indiana.
Aged in a combination of French limousine oak and ex-cognac casks for 10 years. Holy shit.
Tingle.
It is then shipped to Barbados and blended with single blended rum aged in ex-bourbon cask for a minimum of 8 years in Barbados. Wow, this is involved.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of rum that spends a lot of time on boats.
Yeah, yeah, this is boat-aged rum.
Makes it more piratey.
Yeah, it does, yeah.
It's bottled at 43%. And as you can see, comes with a very nice, very sleek, three-quarter stubby bottle with very little in the way of fairy tales or nonsense.
Yeah, this is a classy-ass bottle, by the way. This looks really good on a bar shelf.
The turquoise seal on the neck looks a little out of place, but the chunky synthetic cork stopper, nice timing, underneath gives the satisfying pop. I cannot. This is right off of their website. We didn't plan this. It is noted that there are no additives whatsoever in this rum, which I believe if it's Foursquare, including caramel coloring. So here we go.
And so I'm just going to give everybody, before I make the Manhattan, I'm going to give everyone just a little splash so we can smell it and try it neat. So just clean your glass.
As you do.
Because that's what the Manhattan's going in.
Real fast, this is a 3.5 star from Fat Rum Pirate.
That still says the fat rump I rate.
That's a 5. On rumratings.com, it's a solid 7.6. There's, you know, that's out of 61 ratings, one of which is a 2, one of which is a 5, and the remainder bounds between 6 and 9, with 25 being the mean, or a 25 at 8 and 18 at 7. So that's where you're getting your solid 7.5.
Smells smooth.
Smells, yeah, there's not a lot of...
It's very Foursquare.
It's not harsh at all.
The nose is very Foursquare. It's that traditional, non-over-processed.
Yeah. It
a lot of burn
yeah,
to it.
It's a good point. I can taste the Foursquare in this.
There's not actually a lot of burn. There's burn.
Compared to the Venezuelan one, where the burn was all the way at the end, I get a little bit of burn at the beginning.
Forward burn, not the afterburn. Yeah.
Yes.
I'm getting excited. This tastes like it would make a good Manhattan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
By the way, I talked about this. So Sandy and I, while you're gonna concoct over there,
I'm just gonna start concocting, and then I'll read the.
At what point do we need the recipe all at once. At what point do we need to give Garrick a lab coat?
I have one. I should have brought it.
Yeah, right now. what the hell? No, I was gonna say. So Sandy and I are taking a mini vacation, which is overdue. Sandy and I haven't had any like really just us time in a very long time. And Friday, the airing of this episode is her birthday, so I want to say happy birthday to Sandy.
Happy birthday, Sandy!
Happy birthday, Sandy!
And so we're going down to Palm Beach, South Florida, just north of West Palm Beach, and I wanted to mix it up. I don't want to just go down there and because we got a nice junior suite room, whatever, a lot of points saved up from all the travel and what have you. So. Spoiling ourselves, using up all of our points to stay there. But I'm taking vodka, blue cheese, and olives. I'm going to stuff my own olives and make dirty martinis in the room.
That sounds like an awful lot of work.
That sounds classy.
It sounds classy, but it feels like a Whole Foods would really do it.
No. I got to say, getting the pre-done blue cheese olives is terrible.
Really?
Oh, yeah. You want the blue cheese fresh. You don't want it soaking in that brine. It kills that flavor. So for a dirty martini, the stuffed right as you use them olives are just, there's no comparison.
Yeah.
By the way, Demo Dave
approves
of that message. He and I have had many lengthy conversations on the perfect olives.
I'm a big fan of the blue cheese olive, and the ones you stuff yourself or the bartender does in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
Several orders of magnitude better than the stuff in the cans.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That stuff, like...
It's not even on the same planet.
That blue cheese sitting in the brine changes the blue cheese. It's not...
Yeah, it's not blue cheese anymore. Yeah. It's... Yeah, I know.
I'm glad that we agree.
I'm glad that we agree.
Garrick, you're not really a blue cheese person anyway, right?
I enjoy all of the cheese, so...
Mm.
I mean, green gets a little weird.
Did you bring your own cherries? I have so many cherries.
Give me your cups back. I didn't know if you had the classy cherries.
I have the classy cherries.
Oh, well.
I've got like a jar and a half of them.
Well, these I actually had at my house. Unlike the other ingredients I had to rescue from my parents' place, which is where all my bar accoutrement are currently residing.
Again, while you're over there, I'm non sequitur, bouncing from topic to topic just to fill.
When's the last
silence?
Time we were actually a sequitur?
Good point. Yeah, we just need to rename the show.
Yeah.
Not
sequitur, non sequitur.
Yeah,
rum and nerdy and non sequitur.
Yeah, rum and non sequitur.
Rum and nerdy and squirrel.
You know,
rum and nerdy and squirrel.
Yeah, and squirrel. Yeah, I. You know what? We've already got a theme
moose
song.
And squirrel, but you have to put the emphasis on the right syllable.
Moose and squirrel. Anyway, I was watching a thing, and because fall's coming up, and the season of all things pumpkin spice.
And all I have to say is fuck fall.
Fall sucks.
It was,
so does summer.
Black, yeah.
Spring's kind of nice. Winter's for the birds. Fuck.
That's what
anyway,
we're in Florida.
So pumpkin spice comes up, and again, I was watching, and it was one of those TikToks where somebody is fact-checking whether or not somebody's claim is total bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
And this was one part Fireball whiskey, three parts pineapple juice, and it's supposed to taste like pumpkin pie.
Okay.
And the person fact-checking the thing mixed it up and was like, you saw their face go, oh, this just isn't even fair. This is like yellow and blue make green, but for some reason, when you're making cocktails, yellow and blue make like plaid. It just doesn't
they've make, gone to plaid.
It doesn't make any freaking sense that they're making this drink out of a cinnamon whiskey and pineapple juice, and it tastes like pumpkin pie. So I want to make that.
I was about to say, so does it?
I have not made it yet. I just saw it today, but it was. It occurred to me.
But it was proven
that at the IAPA kickoff party, I might make some of this.
Ooh,
and
yeah.
Do a floater of whipped cream vodka.
Nice.
Okay. Nice. Very, very festive of you.
Okay, so real quick, the Rum Manhattan that we just put together. 1 ounce of the, what did we decide we were calling it? Equiano? Equiano?
That one.
Equiano.
Equiano. 1 ounce of that rum. 1/2 ounce of sweet vermouth. I have substituted with cream sherry because I've started doing that because I think the cream sherry is better than sweet vermouth. And it's in the same family and it's delicious. Leave me alone. 1/2 teaspoon of maraschino liqueur, 1 dash of orange bitters, and then an orange twist to serve.
Did you express the oranges?
I did. And then there's a cherry shown as garnish in the little image that they shown. So I added a fancy cherry, which I brought from my house.
Do I have to drink this with my pinky up?
Per the earlier discussion I had with Greg. Yeah, it's a freaking Manhattan, man. Pinky's out.
Yeah. Readjust my mic. You know, and I still say I love these stands because as much as you just adjusted, it was surprisingly quiet.
Surprising. Yeah, you heard me fighting with the clamp that I had to undo. So anyway, so
very citrusy.
Yeah, it is very citrusy.
And not as, yeah, I don't know. The nose, I'd say similar. The cinnamon simple syrup rum old fashioned. That's
yeah. It is. It does have a cinnamon quality.
Yeah, that's interesting. There's not a lot of. I don't taste the cinnamon, but it's just. It's very fruity.
So,
that might be the cherry liqueur.
The maraschino liqueur.
We might need to do this with the.
That's the thing. When I was reading the ingredients list, I was like, really? Like the maraschino. Luxardo, maraschino liqueur. Really? Really? In a Manhattan? Okay. I don't know if I'm buying it.
I don't.
I think that's the taste that I'm tasting that I'm like, it'd be better if it didn't have that.
I agree with you. There is the palate of that has this discordant note to it.
That's a $20 word.
Discordant note. That's the perfect way. Okay, so here's the other thing.
Should we change the name of the episode to Discordant Note?
The Discordant episode. So like when you get a Manhattan and you're expecting to taste a Manhattan and here's your Manhattan and it's like all the ingredients in the right place, but I think that liqueur shouldn't be there.
Because the beginning of this is pretty good. The finish of it is pretty good. But in the middle, it's like a concert pianist.
Act two of this drink is bullshit.
Act two of this drink is like a concert pianist going through Tchaikovsky.
Did you say penis?
Pianist. But I like where your head's at. And then right in the middle of... right in the middle of his playing, he starts to play with his forehead for no reason.
I'm going to be honest with you. I'm making another
mental
one.
Mental note.
I'm making another
check
one of
the adult content box when I upload this episode.
I'm going to make another one of these without the liqueur. I think
that's required.
And if you handed me this and you said, "Would you like a rum the cocktail?" I'd drink it. And if you truthfully, if you put a big cube in this or something, I'd be like, "Oh yeah, this is not
Cuban."
Yes, put a Cuban in my cup. Yeah, I've been to Havana. Awesome. It probably wouldn't be bad, but the fact that you're calling it Manhattan,
it doesn't line up with a Manhattan.
It doesn't.
No, it really doesn't. I mean,
I'm not opposed to that because honestly, I don't drink Manhattans.
You're not a Manhattan guy.
No,
I love a good Manhattan. Oh,
you don't. You still have a neck. You can't have a neck and
the after
he's
the,
got a neck
after the summit. The was it Hearthstone? We go to at Grand Californian. They make a mean Manhattan.
Like you've said that on many occasions.
Yeah, usually when I'm there, drinking their Manhattan.
You were drinking a Manhattan the night that we were. I don't want to use the word dared, but I will. Dared into doing a podcast. You were drinking a Manhattan then.
I was because I was there. I think at that place.
This whole adventure was the fault of that bar and conversations having been had.
Most good stories start, so there I was at the bar.
And it's basically what it was.
No good story.
And our regular listeners will know this story, but since you probably don't, our friend Lisa, I think she's been on the show, but her husband definitely was. We did a whole interview. He's an actor, done a lot of shows. We did an episode with him, but she was there, and Garrick and I, and anybody that knows us knows this show is just us doing what we normally do.
This is literally hanging out with us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With microphones.
Well, I mean, how many times in the last, since I got here, have you said, be quiet, this needs to go on the podcast?
Yeah.
Most of the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, most of the time. So
that's all it is.
Yep.
Lisa, she looked at us and was just like, you guys are hilarious. You need to do a podcast with this. And there's another part of the story, but we don't really tell that part of the story anymore.
No,
it's the creation of the name of the previous
creation
podcast. So
I will look forward to that off air.
Yeah,
it's not that interesting. It's just we try to not promote the old podcast on this show.
Fair.
Just because we think we might lose some viewers, some listeners.
Oh wait, I think I saw the commercial that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're with the special voice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, one of them. Yeah. Ooh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was 2020. It was a different time.
Yeah, it was.
Many years ago.
Yeah. So we wanted to focus on the fun. But anyway, that's how this all started, was in Hearthstone. You were drinking.
That should be our tagline. Rum and Nerdy, focus on the fun. I'll be honest with you. I thought I, until the day I die, will maintain that it was that conversation happened at Trader Sam's over a Kungaloosh.
I so vividly remember the conversation. That's one of the nights that we put all of the table, and like we still have a picture of you and I down on the end of the table, but we had pushed like 15 tables together and there was 35 of us.
Hmm.
All of the international Eastern board, there was all the different boards that were there at Summit were all at this really long table.
That's the TEA board members, not the table boards that we pushed together.
Correct. But that was the same night that, like, Dan, who's been on the show, who's my current boss, that was the night that Dan and I were telling stories back and forth, and we looked at each other and goes, did we just become best friends? We've been great friends ever since that night. That was such a great night. I remember very vividly.
Hmm.
Can't remember the names of people, but that night I remember.
Except for Dan and Lisa.
So as an almost non sequitur, I have been to the actual Catalina wine mixer now.
Really?
There is one on Catalina in Avalon with a helicopter, and it's
the freaking Catalina
in Avalon.
One.
Isn't that a John Tesh album?
It's also a city on Catalina Island.
That's funny.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's what the album's named after.
Could be.
Again, just because Squirrel, did you, like, we never really discussed it. Lisa had offered to do promotions and marketing for our podcast for an exchange for a producer credit on it.
We should do that.
Yeah. It's like anybody that wants to, like, we'll title the hell out of that. But we were telling us, we were joking about that earlier on the other thing, but the
DemoLisaPro.com.
Yeah. But,
no, 100%.
Yeah. Anything to get more listeners?
Sure.
And we help her out too. Like she was being interviewed and she has some questions.
Interview prep. We do a lot of interview prep. If you're going into an interview and you want some answers, We can give those to you.
Some answers?
Yes.
Do you know which portion of those answers you have, or do you just figure out that there's only a few you get?
I'm an expert in everything that I pretend to tell you.
Yes.
Yeah, that's like, be good at lying, because then you're good at everything.
Ooh.
That's a Greg thought.
That is a Greg thought.
I got to bring those back.
Yeah.
I got to rebrand them all.
Yeah, because they're from the previous
thing. They all have the, yeah, they all have the old thing on them, but some of those are just gold.
Yeah. I forgot that there was a couple that use, like, the one about, now that I'm a parent, I understand.
I understand that scene in Star Wars where Yoda got so fed up with answering Luke's questions, he just died.
Brilliant. Hey, I'm looking at the clock again, and just because we went blown through like kind of the first break, let's take a last one so we can make sure that we fit it in, and we'll be back. Is that cool?
Yes.
And scene.
We'll have Manhattan, the Bronx, and Staten Island too. It's lovely going through the zoo. It's very fancy on old Delancey Street, you know. The subway charms a soul when balmy breezes blow to and fro. And tell me what street compares with Mott Street in July. Sweet push carts gently gliding by. The great big city's a wondrous toy, just made for a girl and boy. We'll turn Manhattan into an isle of joy.
Hey, everybody, welcome back to segment three, whatever it is.
Back to one.
Yeah. It's funny. It's like that break for us just took an hour. We got talking about things that just, if it makes sense, we talked about things that aren't appropriate for our podcast.
We talked about things you need to fix with Brum.
It was basically meeting 2.0 from the, yeah, when we,
the pre-meeting.
Before we started. Yeah, we had the pre-meeting.
And over the course of the post-meeting, I remade that Manhattan minus the liqueur.
And?
I like it much better.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. It's,
there you go.
It's much more Midtown now, so, and less Staten Island.
This is like a solid Manhattan. This is a
this
solid
tastes
Manhattan.
Nothing like a trash can. What are you talking about?
this is a solid Manhattan. I would, I'm going to be honest with you. I bought this for, was it the Hemingway daiquiri?
I think I bought
this for the Hemingway daiquiri.
I remember that episode, yeah.
And I didn't like it in that. I didn't like it in this Manhattan. I have yet to drink anything.
This is like data drinking prune juice.
I hate this.
More? Yes, please.
No, this is close. This is like the Malort of liqueur. I'm going to continue to experiment with different concoctions to put this in, trying to find something that makes it not taste like dick.
And
how would you know?
It tastes so bad.
Is Aaron the Malort of our friends?
Ouch. Wow. Wow. And I came bearing gifts. Okay. And this is how you treat me?
Okay. You're the Mad Dog 2020.
Malort is kind of, there you go. Malort is kind of ginger. I don't,
Malort is kind of, oh God, it's like antifreeze mix with paint.
I'm gonna do some over the week, that, you know, our little 1 week break, I'm going to put some serious effort into figuring out something to make with this bullshit liqueur.
For next week?
Yeah, for next week. There's got to be something out there that it tastes good in.
I got to say.
It smells good.
You have to do the full outfit with the lab coat and the tidy whities.
I take it back. It doesn't smell good. I don't know what to do with this.
Maybe it's, I don't know.
It looks like a cool bottle.
It does.
I love the wicker bottle thing.
It's got that Chianti wrap.
I love Luxardo Maraschino cherries. They're like, that's the pinnacle of cherries. And yet the liqueur is hot garbage. You know what the
you know what
this liqueur tastes like or smells like? It tastes like a cat ate a whole bunch of maraschino cherries and then puked them up on the carpet an inch away from the tile out of spite. Like, that's exactly what this is.
It's like one of those things where, you know, there's this special breed of gerbil that eats guano and out of a cave and then vomits something that...
It's like civet coffee?
Yeah, exactly.
So many...
That's the one where, like, there's a thing that eats the berries and then digests the berries.
Yeah,
and
that's
then
the cat in it.
Yeah, the civet.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like, yeah. I was trying to give context to the...
Please just let me sit here and drink rum and not think about this.
Yeah.
It's like a, yeah, civet coffee, but it's more like a domestic short-haired liqueur.
It's what happens if a hairless cat takes a shit in the carpet.
Moving on. Can't land them all. This is what I've learned.
No, you cannot. So, they're not all winners.
And I want to come back to actually last week. We should talk about last. But I do want to mention, right before, I'm just going to go to last week.
What the hell was last week?
So, Okay, dear listeners, we didn't talk about this last week, but last Thursday, on the eve of last episode airing.
Oh, episode eve.
Episode eve, as you, like, Garrick and I and a group of friends, we went and saw Roger Waters here in Orlando, and it was.
We offered a ticket to Aaron, and he didn't go.
I was conflicted with other things.
Like,
no, I was conflicted with the same thing, and I'm like, Roger Waters.
This was Theater in the Round. We were right there on the corner of the stage.
Oh, on the floor.
On the floor.
Floor seats, yeah.
Right on the corner of one of the, because it was kind of a big X in the floor. We were like right on the end.
Mm-hmm.
And even after the intermission, they brought Roger in, and he was like 10 feet from us.
Oh, yeah. He came up after intermission. He was dressed up in the full wall outfit with, you know, the leather coat and the Nazi-esque
the Third Reich thing.
And so they're getting ready for it. And the security guards, because, again, we're on the floor. So the security guards had kind of roped off our section, and they're holding the crowd.
Well, they were hand-holding rope, but, yeah,
the security guards, yeah, they're blocking off that area. And Todd was sitting next to me, and I leaned over. I'm like, dude, something's getting ready to happen behind us. And he's just looking at the stage, and the band is kind of setting back up. He's like,
yeah.
Dude, you know, it's going on in front of us, man. Like, why are you looking behind us? I'm like, no, there's seriously some shit going on behind us. And we look over because the entrance, you know, this was in the Amway Arena in Orlando. So it's the basketball arena. The entrance where that just goes to the understage, you know.
Restrooms, back of house.
Restrooms, yeah. The big opening into the thing. Roger's just hanging out under there. Again, like what? 20 feet from us?
Yeah.
He's just right over there waiting for his cue to start marching on stage, just looking over, and it's like, dude, Todd, fuck, right there.
He's right.
It's Roger, right there.
We're at now. He's right there.
He's right there.
I can see him.
He came out, because he went to every, you know, all the four corners of the stage. I think as far as production in the round is concerned, I thought this was really well done.
He
would come out to the end of the aisles on the cross for certain songs. Ours was Wish You Were Here.
Yeah.
Oh,
I've got a
so
really
good.
Did you see the video?
So good. Yeah.
I did a video where it's slow pull in and slow pull out.
I got I'm gonna post videos of that concert to everybody. I need to, and hopefully by the time this airs, those will already have posted. I need to get them off the Dropbox and post the high quality ones.
Well, the reason I brought that up is because it goes back to the can't land them all, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we're in the car on the way. My son, Riley, who he was on the previous show. He wasn't on this show. He hasn't been on this show yet. We should totally have him on this show.
We
should. Yeah, you should.
He was our first guest.
He was our first guest on the
previous
show.
You should have
him back. He's a
it's not like he's
good
upstairs
kid.
Or anything.
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of fun. But we're all, like, he and I are in the back seat. You and your sister, who mm-hmm. had gone,
yep.
in the front seat. You're driving. And as is typical, we're in the car, we're joking around, we're always in character. This is us. We're, like, we are it now,
yeah,
we're it then.
I love the fact that
is,
you say we're in character, like this is different from just who we are.
That's my point. So this is just who we are. And so I say a joke or whatever, and it's like crickets in the car, and I'm like, well, can't land them all, which is this ongoing thing with you and I. And,
yeah.
You know, and I land about 70%. I've got a good average.
You're pretty good, yeah.
But every once in a while, it's just total crickets.
Yeah. You got a bomb once in a while. It keeps you humble.
No, it's like, oh, that was a Dennis Millerism. That was some random-ass political reference.
I said that, yes, and I said that in a meeting. I'm pointing at Aaron. I said that in a meeting earlier today. I'll explain that after Greg's story.
Yeah. So we're sitting there, and it was just crickets. And I say that, and your sister laughs at that joke, just like you and I laughed the first time I said it. Fast forward an hour and a half. We're sitting at dinner. We're sitting around the table, blah, blah. And I say something and everybody at the table laughs. And she looks across and goes, well, that one you landed. I was like, yeah.
It's almost like she's related to me.
Speaking of being in cars with you two, when we went to, I think it was, we saw Dune when that came out. Yeah. And we drove all the way down to Point Orlando. And you know, so you both know my superpower. I can nap anywhere.
Yes.
I have a very similar superpower.
Yeah. And especially on boats, we can go full speed. And I think you've seen this now in real life, and I don't know that you have.
I've seen the video. It's hilarious.
Full speed, I can be passed out completely, holding a bucket of rum and a cigar. The cigar will not ash, the rum will not spill, but I will be snoring.
Yeah. So this is true.
Yeah. So we're driving down there, and you guys. I'm asleep in the back.
I think this was my fault. I think I was the one.
Go ahead. Set the stage for the listeners. This is I-4 after work, 5 o'clock traffic.
Rush hour traffic
in Orlando. And we're driving down to the point. So we're crossing downtown Orlando, which is sort of this traffic hellhole.
Yes. And, stop and go traffic. And you guys are chatting away. And I'm like, you know what? Time for a nap. So I just lean against
guys are boring.
It was a conscious decision.
Yeah, I was like,
just like our podcast listeners, he decided to just check out.
And sleep. And then all of a sudden, you hit the. I think Garrick, you were driving.
Okay, so Aaron's asleep. Let's go over to Greg and Garrick's perspective of the situation.
Yes.
Hey, I think Aaron's asleep in the back. I got an idea. I'm gonna jam on the brakes violently and suddenly, and everyone needs to start screaming. Okay, ready?
Yeah, and it was like,
yeah.
Ah!
Yeah. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and I timed it just right, driving to like where, hey, there's kind of a break in the traffic. I could probably get it up to like 70 in here, and then really hit the brakes, without engaging ABS, and it was
So you do this. I can feel the G force. And then you guys go,
The G-Force has sold it. I mean,
and I woke up and I went, oh, I'm not going to die.
This is what it's like to shit yourself.
My airplane's not on fire? Okay, I'm going back to bed.
Yeah, there was almost no reaction whatsoever.
Yeah. Zero foxes, that's going to be your... That's my call sign. That's your call sign.
See, and that's before you guys knew all the rest of the crazy crap.
And this is Zero Fucks. Right?
So we all have rum names. That's your rum name, Zero Fucks.
I like it.
Yours is Rum Sifu.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Obi Rum Kenobi.
Ah.
John is Rum Sensei.
That's a good one.
We haven't given Sean one yet.
Sean needs one,
I feel like mine breaks with the rum theme.
Yeah, Zero Fucks is a good just general handle.
It is.
I think you need a rum. I think you need a specific rum name.
Yeah. don't worry. Wait 5 minutes. I'll do something stupid. You can use that.
Greg might have thought of one. He's laughing.
I'm just like something.
He's laughing a lot.
My mind goes to like plastic bottle or something like
plastic. What?
What? Because it's like because he's the cheap rum would come.
This is nice rum. Both of the rums that he brought today. So this, what do we call this? Equiano. This is not a cheap rum.
No,
and it's not a bad rum either. This is a solid rum, solid price. Absolutely recommend it. This Venezuela rum, which was in the do we call it? The White Claw lineup
different Mountain Dew Code Red area.
Yeah, the Mountain Dew Code Red of rums on the thing. Also, not a bad rum.
And to be fair,
not terrible.
Half the price of the Equiano, and not bad.
Wouldn't have bought it at all if it didn't say Venezuela on it.
You have a weird Venezuelan.
I did
fetish, but
wait a minute.
I checked that box with my ex. We're fine.
That was where she was from.
Yeah,
the ex that I know.
Yeah, the one. Yeah.
Were you there the night we were texting?
He helped. You want to tell that story?
Yeah. We don't have a lot of time, but I know I had said something or other about blah blah, and she went off on liberals. She went off on the.
That's not the night I'm talking about.
No, this is when we were all downtown.
Yeah.
and we were all passing my phone around.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm talking about.
She went off on that.
We were
anyway.
At the cigar club.
You had a political discussion via text.
I said something rather about like Hollywood movies, something, and she went off on like.
Oh yeah, she did that.
Hollywood
in the like, text string.
Yeah.
Oh man, she didn't. Like, she didn't need a whole lot of prompting for that.
No, this was like my thing did not land at all, and she went full on. Hollywood is full of perverts and scandals and blah blah blah.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Drinking the blood of babies.
Yeah,
Meanwhile,
one of our friends that we know texted, "Just let me pee in your butt."
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So Aaron's
and
phone,
I dated her for another 6 months.
All of us are blown away that like, that's a real.
Yeah.
Like how? Because she thought everything that was being said was you.
Mm-hmm.
Did you ever correct her?
Mm-mm. You know, your phone got hoard around that bar.
Oh, it was like a hooker in Amsterdam.
It was.
Oh yeah, everybody in the bar says, "Let me." And
like the bar staff got in on it.
Oh yeah, it was the women. There were women there.
Oh yeah,
they were everybody.
She, to this day, she has no idea.
That's crazy. You know, and the funny thing is that the conversations it went from, like, "Hey, we're going to talk about soccer," to Hollywood, to politics,
And the whole thing,
cookie recipe.
And the whole thing started. We're like, she should come out and join us.
Yeah.
Hey, you should come out and join us. I don't want to. And then someone's like, well, give me the phone. I'll convince her to come out. And it just progressed into.
And, well, part of it was me also not wanting to drive home that night, and I could walk to her place from where we were.
I remember this is true.
Oh, I don't remember that. Wow, you did that poorly.
There's
a much better way to have attacked that.
If you wanted
a place to walk to and crash, you could have done that much better.
Yeah. I could. Well, see, I tried that.
You did say earlier that you had a lot of Holiday Inn Expresses.
I just met you 5 minutes ago. Here's my cell phone. Text my girlfriend.
That was after she'd already done something that was not fun. So I'm like,
you had scabs on your face at the time, didn't you? Like there was some sort of
her fault, but not in that way. So we were hammered coming out of
her fault, but not in that way.
Yeah, I was not beaten.
As one does.
But what happened was
it wasn't domestic violence; it was regular violence.
No,
thank
it
you
was
very much.
Yeah. She jumped on my back in a parking garage while I was wearing loafers that didn't have traction on the bottom, and it had just rained.
Oh, well, it's your fault for wearing loafers.
Also, yes. But
hello, 1992.
So she jumped without warning on my back, and I went down on one knee, nearly shattered my kneecap, and then...
Did you just call her fat?
No, unexpected. You've met her.
She's absolutely not fat, but that was funny.
Yeah, and then I apparently stopped to fall with my face.
You know, she's one of our listeners. You are in so much trouble.
Yeah, she has to find me first.
We're currently at the Rum and Nerdy Studios.
Now she'll find me.
Yeah, well, you know, you started it.
This is accurate-ish.
Accurate-ish sums up most of our fact-checking.
Yeah, that's fair.
This was fun.
for an impromptu, oh shit, we need to record tonight. This worked out well.
Yeah. And by the way, like we are getting to a point where we need to get ahead of schedule.
Oh, we do. Yeah. 'Cause Sate's going to kick our ass.
So, starting tomorrow, including my vacation, but it's starting tomorrow.
It's a 5-day weekend. It's a 3-day weekend.
Is it?
For Sandy, it's a 5-day weekend because she's off. She's on vacation, effective immediately. But she's gonna get some stuff done tomorrow. But here's the thing: between now and Thanksgiving, I do not sleep in my own bed 46 nights.
I don't know how far
you really got to get a better madam.
No,
or
it's,
pimp.
It's not
however
that.
It works.
It's like I've got a week in London. And then come back. I've got like 5 days in Tennessee, and then immediately go for 2 weeks in Vegas, and then I come back and I week in LA. Come back for 3 days, and then go to Napa, which I wish I could just stay, but it's a Halloween weekend.
Hmm.
And then so I come back, and then it's IAPA, which even though I'm in Orlando, you know,
you're not in Orlando.
Four or five nights I'm in a hotel, and then.
Ooh.
Then it's after that. It's Thanksgiving, then Atlanta, and then here, then L.A., and then I'll be done.
I need to twist your guy's arm. Go to Itzek.
Itzek.
It's in Orlando. It's right after Thanksgiving.
Is it the
it's the military version of what you guys do.
Yeah, it's what's the actual name of it? It's
Inter Service Industry and Training and Simulation. Conference.
Training and Simulation. Yeah, yeah. I go to that, and I'm on their mailing list. That's a regular thing for
we'll
me.
Go.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, God dang it! How is it expensive ticket?
Mm-hmm. No,
it's $1,000.
Ooh,
you're doing it wrong.
Yeah, probably.
That's hard to swing.
You're doing it wrong. You can hit the floor for free. You just sign up. It's fine. I'll get you a thing.
Yeah, it's not like I have any military contract continuing education courses I need.
Well, no, it's crazy because I know we're out of time, but this is funny. Similar to IAPA, it's like, hey, we do simulation stuff. Here's some technology.
Party!
And there's a part of your themed entertainment thing. You're like, hey, I can use this in my themed entertainment job. When you're walking the floor, there are some simulation things where you're like, I have no use for this. Like the dead body scented, not scented candles. They're like, they're the scent things that simulate rotting flesh.
And
you buy them to train soldiers to not, you know, get freaked out. Yeah, when they go into war zones and all that. But when they light those off in their booth at the convention, you're like, oh.
That's not right.
I did that wrong.
That was the last Itzek I went to.
Send me that photo if you want me to post it to our site. That's fucking hilarious.
So for our viewers, that is me holding a shoulder-launched surface-to-air missile.
More importantly, you're in a suit.
Yeah. Wearing a very expensive...
That doesn't even look
like you. Yeah, wearing a very expensive suit. And this was a... there's obviously not a missile in it, but they were like...
Really? At the Orange County Convention Center? Yeah. There's no live fire? Really?
It's really disappointing.
All right. Okay, we got to go. Greg's giving me the hook.
Greg's angry.
If we keep going, it's going to cost us like $2 extra this month.
I'll put it in your G-string for you.
Dude, you're not selling the panic waving. Like you're waving at me over there like...
No, nah, it's more than like we're pushing 11:30.
You want to go to bed?
Yeah, and I got to drive back.
Oh, yeah, that sucks.
Yeah.
For you.
For me.
You can crash here and just go back in the morning if you want, but we'll talk about it offline.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not worth dragging this. Like, none of the listeners, not one of them give a shit where you sleep tonight.
No, it'd be face down in a gutter for all they care.
I'm just going to forewarn you that you're going to be Little Spoon.
Promise?
He does promise because this will be Garrick's first opportunity to be the big spoon.
Actually, you know. He'll just be in the middle then, wouldn't he?
He's like, you're new to the group. You're the little spoon now.
I mean, I have to assert my dominance somehow.
Well, it's not through your hairline, so.
Ooh. Oh. But true.
Oh.
Harsh but fair.
Yeah, that's big words coming from Ginger.
Well, I still got all of them.
Yeah.
Hey, before you guys say it, I'm fat. ha ha.
Dad yeah. Pods unite.
Yeah, sorry. There's like some Eminem song there. Like, well, now tell them something they don't know about me.
Oh no, it's from 8 Mile.
Yeah,
a surprisingly good movie.
I'm
still haven't seen it.
Surprisingly good movie.
Oh,
it's really good.
That
here's
is
the thing.
Really good. I don't like rap music. That movie's fucking phenomenal.
Yeah, here's the thing.
Eminem is amazing.
Yeah, yeah. Really good actor. Who saw that coming?
Not me.
Not me.
Like, the fact, yeah, nothing bad to say about Eminem and 8 Mile in that movie, the whole thing. Just totally, go watch it. It's really good.
Totally agree.
You still need to watch Stargate Universe.
I need to watch it after Atlantis Season 5, and I have some more hours of television to watch before that.
Actually, I think you can watch Universe independent of the rest of them.
The website that I looked at recommended it at the end.
You know, I don't know them.
You know what? Shut up.
Well, all that said, hey, thanks. Don't forget to check out our website, rumandnerdy.com. That's andnerdy.com.
Social media, also rumandnerdy, at and.
Looking forward to, I'm actually going to, like, here in just a few weeks, be hanging out with our good friend, Dave Martin.
DemoDavePro.com.
Yeah, and we've got to get him on... what was the gag that we were talking about earlier? We got to get him on that.
Fuck, I'll have to listen to the episode to remember the gag we were supposed to get a bit on.
Admittedly, it's late.
Dude, he pulled out that Kanye Conway bullshit, like, immediately.
Just like, yeah.
And it's really good. Yeah.
Yeah.
I still like that meme. If you have hair like this, you have siblings you've never met. Yeah. And it's a picture of Kanye Conway Twitty.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Or Kanye Twitty.
Yeah.
Kanye, maybe.
Yeah. We need to do a mashup photo.
Yee or yeehaw.
Okay. I still think that's a better name.
Yeah.
Nice. Noise. Okay. Well, we do the website. Did we do the website?
Yeah.
Social media.
Yeah.
I think that all that's left is
stay nerdy, my friends.
How about that nutty Star Wars bar? Can you forget all the creatures in there? And hey, Darth Vader in that black and evil mask, did he scare you as much as he scared me? Ah! Star Wars! Those near in Bar Wars! My seventh winner up here! Star Wars!
Humming?
I am.
You are?
Sorry.